There are seven possible actions or behaviors to adopt when the foreign key reference object is deleted. In this tutorial, if you're interested in the seven different options, I'm just going to take you through step by step, provide an example of each, moving through all the different options to the final one, restrict, which really does need a little bit more explanation than the other options. Just before you do start moving through the tutorial, it's worth noting that you can just go ahead and read the Django documentation, the model fields, look for the relationship fields here. It just takes you through the seven different options. There is a small example of some of them. So if you prefer to read, there's definitely some information there, but this tutorial is meant to support this documentation, provide some concrete examples of each. So with that said, let's go ahead now and look at the first option, set null. So here we have the database that we're going to be utilizing here. You can see we have a product foreign key connected to a category table. So for one category, there are many products associated to it. And then we have a reverse foreign key here from product to media, if you like. So we have one product to many images. So to try and set the scene here, imagine we add a new category, say category one, the name of shoe, right? So then we add a new product. Now this new product needs to have a reference here to the category. So this is category one, which is shoe. So we build a new product and then we need to assign a category to that new product. So here we have a reference, say ID number one, which is a reference to ID one here in the category table. So in our product model, where we define the category foreign key, the connection to the category table, here we have the seven possible actions that we can define. So we're going to define an action here, and that is simply just referring to the behavior to adopt when the category is deleted. So if we were to have a new category, ID one, shoes, and then create a new product and then assign that category one here in the product table, whenever we delete an item here in the category table, we're asking ourselves, what should we do to the associated products? So the products that are associated to that category, what should we do when we delete this referenced object from the foreign key, from where the foreign key table is? So if I were to delete, in this case, ID one shoes, then we need to perform some sort of action on this product. Else what we have is a field with products with a random number in it. And of course that number won't refer to anything. So that can cause issues in our database. So just going back to our first option then, set null. So here we have the product table. We've set the category foreign key as set null. Now it's important to, when we are setting null or defining set null, that the null must be true. So by default, this is false. So we need to set also the model here, null equals true, the field. And then we can also set blank equals true. So let's just see what happens here in the products. I've got 10 products here. I've got 10 categories. So category one is associated to product one. So this is product one. You can see it's associated to category one. So let's go ahead and delete the referenced object, which is category one here in categories. So if I were to go ahead and do that, what's happening now, there is no category one. If I go back to products here, you can see that the category has been set to null. So this product no longer is connected to category one. So let's take a quick look at the actual table. So I've got SQLite here extension. We're just using this SQLite. So let's just open this database and have a little look here. So this is going to be in the products table. So you can see here that the item category ID has been set to null. So in some situations that might cause some issues. So you need to be careful here whether you apply that or not, because we are essentially defining a foreign key. So one might assume that we are kind of expecting, depending how your program is developed, we're kind of expecting there to be a connection to a category here. So in addition to that, why else might you have set null? Well, imagine this is, for example, comments, and this is users. And for example, or the other way around, so comments and users. If we delete a user, it doesn't mean necessarily we want to delete all the comments that they've created, because that might be part of some sort of useful narrative that's useful for your particular application. So there might be some occasions where when you do delete the associated referenced object, that you want to keep some that thing that's connected to it, that data. So it's important to understand when and where to kind of utilize set null. So it might be, in fact, a better case in some situations to utilize set default. So here we can specify a default value to adopt when the referenced object is deleted. So in addition to changing on delete to set default, we also need to define the default. So let's just say that the default option is category number 5, for example. So here we can specify the value to set if and when the associated reference object is deleted. So let's go back into, for example, categories. So category 5 is connected to product. So let's do category 10. So category 10 is connected to product 10. So let's just delete category 10. So the expected behavior here is that the product 10 should now be part of category 5. And there we go. So on deleting the referenced object, we're going to set the default option. The default option here is set to 5. And for those who were a little bit slightly confused there, category 5. So what we're doing is we're setting this value here in this table to 5, which is the ID associated to the foreign key over here in the category table. So next up, we have cascade, which is fairly simple to understand. When the referenced object is deleted, it also deletes all the objects that has reference to it. So take our example here. We have category 1. And then we have, say, 100 products that are associated to that category 1. If we were to delete this category, it will also delete all of these products that are associated to that category. Or we'll delete all the products that has a category of the same ID of the ID category that we're trying to delete. So in our example here, category 8 is connected to product 8. So if I were to go ahead and delete this, it also tells me here what's actually going to be deleted. So one product is going to get deleted. Category 8 is being deleted, and then product 8 is also then going to be deleted. And there we go. So that's cascade. Of course, there's some obvious reasons to be concerned here, because maybe you don't want to delete all the items because of the category is deleted. So here you need to be careful to ensure this type of connection. If you are sure that the referenced object, when that is deleted, you also want to delete the items that are referenced to it, then that's a good idea. But there is obviously cases where you don't want to do that, and that's where some of the other options will be more appropriate. So next up, protect pretty much describes itself. So it forbids any deletion of any reference object. So when we go ahead and delete the reference object, it will basically tell us that we can't do that. So let's just give it a go. So category 9 will be connected to product 9. So let's just try and delete this. And you can see here it says deleting category 9 will require you, first of all, deleting the product number 9. So that's literally just telling us that we can't perform this operation. There is no button here now to press. So that's protect. So we're going to prevent. We're going to protect any of the objects that are referencing the item that we're trying to delete from getting or being deleted. So next up, set really is one of the only Django specific items here. The rest of these tools have obviously connotations to SQL, because these need to be converted into SQL to perform the actions on your database. So set, let's take a look. Set allows us to perform some sort of action should we delete the reference object. So we can just utilize set here, and then we can connect this, for example, to a function. So here I have a function called getCategory. It's going to return 11. So let's just make this return, for example, category 2, or the value 2 in this case, sorry. So this function, simple function, is going to return the number 2. So all we need to do here is go back into our model and set, and then just define the function. So with that set, should we delete any of the objects here? So category 6 would be associated to product 6. So let's just go ahead and delete that one. So you can see here, we're also told that one object will potentially be changed, or it's connected to one object, number 6. So product 6 now is part of category number 2. So all that's happened here, of course, is that when the reference model object was deleted, we just run the function, and that's just returning the number 2. So we're just associating this product to category number 2 in this case. So that was useful for you to kind of connect the action to some specific bespoke code. So the next option doesn't really require any introductions, do nothing. So we're going to do nothing. There we go. So this is probably not the best option, and it could possibly create some integrity issues in your database. So just be careful utilizing do nothing. So this brings us on to restrict, which is going to need a little bit of explanation. So I'll try and break this down a little bit. This is probably one of the newer options here brought into Django 3.1. So let's take a look at restrict. So I've gone ahead and applied restrict with the current setup. Let's go ahead and try to remove a category. So category 7, try and delete that. You can see that we're restricted. So by default, in this type of scenario, restrict is going to perform the same in the same way as protect would, in that it's going to protect any product from being deleted if the referencing category ID is deleted first. So to provide an example of restrict, really we need a setup similar to this here. So we're going to need, for example, a table which has two foreign keys connected to two tables here. So let's go ahead and just set this up. All right, so I'm going to add the data manually here. So I'm going to add two categories. So cat 1 and cat 2. And then I'm going to go ahead and go to my brands. And then I'm going to say that brand 1 is part of category 1. And then brand 2 is then part of category 2. Now, this database schema doesn't necessarily make perfect sense. We've got the wrong one here. So we also need a connection, don't we, from brand to category. Apologies. So we've got this connection here. So brand is also a brand is also part of a category. So for one brand, there are for one category, there are multiple brands. So apologies. This is the setup that we're going to go for. So like I said, this isn't necessarily, you wouldn't necessarily associate products to a category and brands to a category, but we're going to give this a go. So then finally, we have one brand connected to one category. So we're going to go ahead and add some products. So we're going to add two products. So we're going to say product one is in category one and then brand one. And then we're going to create a product two, which is part of category two, but brand, category one, sorry, but brand two. Yeah, there we go. So let's just quickly go through this. We have a category here, and you see the brand is connected via a foreign key with Cascade. So we're going to say that if we delete a category, we should then delete the associated brands associated to that category. But in addition to that, we now have the product table, which is associated to the category with Cascade and brand via restrict. So we're definitely saying that if we delete a brand, we don't want to then delete the corresponding row in product. So there's two scenarios here. So let's just, this is the data we've got in the different tables here to help us understand what's going on here. If I were to delete category one here in category, it would mean that with through Cascade in the brand, it would mean that I would be deleting this here, this entry here in brand, But in addition to that, because category is also associated to product via cascade, remember, in addition to that, it will also go ahead and delete any reference in the product where category equals one. So if I just go ahead, now I have all the data in, let's go to category, let's go ahead and delete category one. We're told that it's going to delete both of the products and brand number one. So two products, one brand is going to be deleted by deleting category one. So the behavior is going to be slightly different if we try to delete category two. So let's go ahead and delete category two. That means we have cascade on brand. So category two is associated with this entry here in the table. So we'd expect to delete that because of cascade. However, if we were to delete brand two, notice that we do have a connection to brand two in product, and we're told in the product table that we've set the on delete to restrict. So what that means is that in this case, it won't go ahead and delete brand two in brand and then delete any associated records in the product table. And the reason why it doesn't do that, because there isn't an associated category in the category table. So we're referring to category two. So because category two isn't in the product table here, it's not going to delete this field. So we're going to be restricted from actually deleting category two in this case. So we can see that in action. Let's just go back to categories, category two. And there we go. So we're told that we can't do it because the following objects are protected, prod two. If I were to actually change restrict to protect, this will give you an idea of the reasons why you'd want to use protect or restrict. So I've changed that to protect. So I just need to make migrations. So what I've done here is I've moved brand from restrict to protect, just to showcase the fact that with protect, you're going to find that we can't delete the first category. And this is one of the main differences, really. So let's go back into the categories. So before with restrict, I was able to actually delete category one. So I put protect on now, and you can now see we can't perform that action. So unlike protect, deletion of the reference object is allowed if it also references a different object that is being deleted in the same operation. So because we're deleting cat one, we're able to then delete cat one and brand one. Now brand is connected here to over here, so we'd imagine that we'd want to delete this here. However, we're saying that because there is a referenced object cat one here to this cat one here, although we're not deleting brand two here, it does mean because there's a referenced object in the product table with cat one, it means we'll also delete this entry two in the database. So that's going to take a little while potentially to sink in. By all means, go ahead and just try that out. Maybe go to the Django documentation, have a look at their example with artists and albums and songs, and then just try it out for yourself to kind of get that to sink in, because it can be quite a good pattern to utilize in certain situations. So I do hope by visualizing the seven options, it then is a little bit easier to understand what tools you have available now for setting the on delete behavior on foreign keys. So I do hope that was useful, and I'll see you in the next tutorial, hopefully.